May I show you what you are going to do? This is our first scene.
I know my lines.
Lines? Lines are nothing. This is the baby that makes them or breaks them.
The microphone.
Amazing how many people it has destroyed.
Action.
My mother-in-law said traveling was bad for you. She said it addles a brain. She must have traveled a lot when she was young.
Cut.
You mustn't forget the microphone.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, you silent picture people. You have such a time remembering the microphone, huh? Well, shall we start it again? Interlock and roll.
Red light.
52, take two.
Action.
My mother-in-law said traveling was bad for you. Said it addles a brain. I got an idea she traveled a lot when she was young.
Cut.
Idea, and I want the words pear-shaped.
Idea.
Now let me hear the next two lines.
Well, I can only stay a week. Father's arranged to have me rehabilitated.
To have you what?
To have me rehabilitated.
Rehabilitated.
Oh, sure, rehabilitated.
Now, shall we try it from the top?
Yeah.
Interlock and roll on.
52, take three.
Action.
My mother-in-law said traveling was bad for you. She says it addles a brain. She must have traveled a lot when she was young. I can only stay a week. My father's arranged to have me rebuild. I'm sorry.
Cut.
Camera reloading.
Yes?
I had an idea for a piece of business coming down the stairs.
You did?
Yeah. Since this character is supposed to be kind of awkward, I thought maybe I could do a fall and end up sitting at their
feet. Why?
I just thought it would be funnier if I could put a little action in it.
Some more action in it than you have had in the last year.
Sure, it's just that I thought if I could put a little pantomime routine in...
Pantomime is dead, Mr. Keaton. Pictures now talk.
Goddamn bone in your body. Free.
Everybody.
He stopped running away from
me. Loves to see me get hit in the face.
No, not everybody. I don't like to see you get hurt.
Everybody.
I love you.
Everybody. Everybody laughs at a clown. Everybody loves a clown.
I did Buster's, supposedly, his life story. But and I, at that particular time, after that picture, I didn't want to make any more films. It was a lousy experience for me.
Really?
It was dishonest. I mean, it's an entertaining picture when you look at it, but they lost the dimension, the most important person. They lost Buster Keaton. Buster didn't have that authority, you see. He was in a little bit of trouble at that time. And here you're dealing with a man, not only his great genius, he was the D.W. Griffith of motion pictures.
He was, right.
Of comedy. And that's just one side of him. But then you go into the man himself. So we were raised quite a bit alike. In the family act, when I was born into it, we did a comedy knockabout act. And Buster and I, our lives parallel one another in that area.
Right.
And Buster had a fantastic life, exciting, wonderful, and everything else you can think of. And not to have that fulfilled on the screen, that was very. I wanted to quit after that. I didn't like the director, didn't like the writing, I didn't like anything because it was dishonest.
From Hollywood to Las Vegas, with Donald O'Connor and Irene Ryan next. She's Granny of the Beverly Hillbillies, and Donald's making like Big Dan Blocker a bonanza for his latest nightclub act, which premiered at the Sahara. Well, these two, it's like old times clanning around together. Years and years ago, they were together in vaudeville. Of course, they were pretty young at the time, and both have come a long way from those early days. And speaking of those days, we asked Donald and Irene to tell us what it was like.
How far do you want to go back?
Well, I can go back, I think, further than Donald. I know his family goes back as far as I do. But I'm going to tell Donald the last time I worked with the family and Donald was, I can't remember the year, but it was the year of the earthquake in Long Beach.
Oh, for heaven's sake. You know, I forgot all about that. That was in 1933.
Was that it?
Yeah, we were working up on the main street there.
The Strand.
That's it. We'd just gone out for a supper show.
That's right.
You know what I was doing at the time? We were over at the Entre Cafeteria, and I'd just gone up for a second plate of macaroni, and the thing hit.
And I remember when we came in, Donnie was saying, "Oh, you should have been here. Everything was shaking." He was a little feller then.
Yeah, I was 27 at the time.
No, you weren't, Don.
That was really something. Was that the last time we worked together?
That was the last time we worked. Soon after that, Donald, I think you got a pretty good break in pictures and went on to pretty big things.
Well, Patsy, you know,
right.
Patsy, she was first because she took over Shirley Temple's place.
Right.
And I started in 1938.
Right, that's what I thought.
And I got my break. When was the first time we worked together? Do you think you remember?
I can't remember that, Donald. I know the earthquake made an impression on me because you were so excited about it. He wasn't scared. He just thought it was great that everything was shaken.
Yeah, I couldn't talk for 2 weeks.
$60 down and $20 to go. And we go to Mr. John Carson.
I wouldn't say a word about it.
Donald, have you been drinking?
Where else I go?
You are the one that left the room, dear.
The Joker is me. There's always a Joker in the pack. There's always a cardboard clown. A poor painted fool falls on his back, and everyone laughs when he's down. There's always a funny man in the game, but he's only funny by mistake. But everyone laughs at him just the same. They don't see his painted heart break. They don't care as long as there is a jester, just a fool, as foolish as he can be. There's always a joker, that's a rule, and fate deals the hand, and I see the joker is me. The joker is me. The joker is me.
Take me to the rooftop. I wanna see the world when I stop breathing, turning blue. Tell me love is endless. Don't be so pretentious. Leave me like you do. If you need me, wanna see me, better hurry, 'cause I'm leaving soon. Sorry, can't save me now. Sorry, I don't know how. Sorry, there's no way out. Sorry, but down. Salty tears on my cheek. That's what a year-long headache does to you. I'm not okay. I feel so scattered. Don't say I'm all that matters. Leave me. Deja vu.